Pawn Stars have been a reality TV series for almost a decade. The Golden Silver Pawn Shop is ran by the Harrison family and Chumlee Russell. People come from all over to Las Vegas, Nevada to visit the pawn shop and to exchange some rare items to collect some serious cash. Over time, fans started to wonder if the show was actually real or if everything was scripted. Of course, it's a reality TV series, but how real is it really? There are a few things that go on behind the scenes that you probably don't know. And in today's video, we're going to talk about some things you don't know about Pawn Stars employees. But before we do, make sure you are subscribed to the channel. What viewers don't see on the show is that like every other pawn shop, the Golden Silver Pawn Shop has taken in stolen property on occasion despite the great efforts they make under state and local laws and regulations to avoid doing so. They once bought some gold coins that had been stolen, as it later turned out, but melted them down before the rightful owner could come to claim them, which led to a lawsuit that was later settled out of court. While these kinds of things happen off camera more than one would think, it actually also happened on the show once. In one episode, Rick bought a 2,000-year-old Tyron Shekel, a coin most historians believe was made of currency, using an infamous transaction of 30 pieces of Judas, paid to Judas to betray Jesus Christ. A detective later came to the shop and informed him that the coin had been stolen not by the seller who was featured in the episode, but by a previous possessor of the coin. However, the Harrisons were allowed to keep it in the end, as the original owner had been compensated by his insurance policy. Over the past 3 decades, Rick has purchased a lot of weird items in the pawn shop. According to him, the weirdest thing he owns is some 200-year-old Japanese porn. It's all hand-painted, it's on a scroll down to every bodily fluid, everything's really exaggerated, it's sort of creepy. And then, after I bought it, I realized my mother comes into the pawn shop, so I couldn't display it out there. But this is not even the strangest thing they have ever been offered, as a guy once bought a sack full of human skulls. He reportedly claimed to have bought the skulls in an auction at a dental school, but it's hardly surprising that Rick decided to pass on them. At the beginning of each episode of Pawn Stars, Rick reminds us that you never know what is going to come through that door. And on March 23rd, 2016, he was proven all the more right when a group of Max intruders entered the Golden Silver Pawn Shop with shotguns and pistols. The Pawn Stars stated, "We are a heavily armed store. The doors are usually locked. We've actually never been robbed the entire time we've been here, but the History Channel show has given us a lot of more notoriety since we are a bigger target." So after nearly 20 years in business, the Harrison shop was unfortunately robbed for the very first time, and according to Rick, the thieves stole over $250,000 in cash and merchandise, mostly sports paraphernalia and coins. Following the robbery, the pawn shop had to close for a few weeks to sort everything out. While the show was likely on a break anyway at the time, and just like we are used to hearing him say on the show, Rick also said, "Thankfully, I got a buddy of mine who knows a thing or two about property insurance. So I gave him a call and he's coming down to help out." Last, we have the fact that it is nothing new that reality shows are scripted. But in 2013, the Writers Guide of America published a report revealing prevalent abusive overwork of reality TV script workers based on a survey of members who had worked in the industry in the 6 years prior to the report. The majority stated to have worked unpaid overtime during those years with last minute script rewrites, forcing them to work long hours in order to meet the deadlines. Being one of the most common reasons, according to the reports, writers and producers have been losing an estimated $40 million annually in unpaid overtime and people working for Lightfield Entertainment. The production company behind Pawn Stars were among the ones affected by the law, pay rates as well. So that's all we have for today's video, guys, and we'll see you next time.